Hey guys, welcome to NautiStyles. We are back in Southern California in our neighborhood of Marina Del Rey, and we found a really interesting possibility for our affordable liveaboard yacht series. Welcome back. Make sure you stay all the way to the end for the outtakes. Trust me, you don't want to miss it. If you are interested in learning more about liveaboard lifestyle, make sure to check us out on the Patreon, where we spend time and focusing on this specific subject. We discuss the pros, the cons, the cost, the possibilities. If you guys have any specific questions, we're able to answer directly, so definitely check us out on the Patreon. This is a 1997 Navigator 56 Sundance. The reason we want to show you this one is because someone has spent a lot of time and money to do the right upgrades, so it would make a great liveaboard. Let's check it out. This is a great swim platform. Feels very solid. It's a lot wider than I would expect it.
Yeah, I see the water inlet right there and the shore water inlet and a transom shower.
It's nice that it has a railing here. It's definitely wide enough to put some chairs and do some fishing.
Oh, for sure. 100%.
I like the rails everywhere. It just feels nice and safe.
You could easily add some rod holders if you want to, just put them in. All the shore power inlets are over there, as well as the internet inlet. Really good size cockpit.
Come on up. Look at this door. It looks very serious. Ah, this is kind of neat. Check this out. Make a great little storage for, you know, stuff that you use in like maybe proper boxes for fishing. You can put your tackle and stuff here.
Mm-hmm.
If you like it to look more clean and polished, you can actually put a little drop down enclosure here, you know, like the white mesh that we see sometimes.
Sure. And just cover it.
Yeah, just cover it if you don't want to see it. Yeah, but you can nicely organize yourself here. Is this our engine room access?
That's the access to the engine room. That's right.
Cool.
The lazarette and the engine room.
So we do that later. Here are rod holders.
There are some rod holders. Mm-hmm. Yeah, mounted on the rails. There,
one on the other side as well.
On the starboard side as well.
What's different on this yacht that we cannot go forward? There's no walkway forward.
Yeah, you do have the rail here you could probably walk on. And then you can hold on above there. But yeah, you don't have the walkways on the sides, which gives you a lot larger salon because it's a full beam of the boat.
Absolutely. But it is set up that way because there's a little step up here.
Yes.
So you can go up here and you have a rail on top and rail here. So if you are brave, you can totally do that. So if you need to get to those places for whatever reason, you can definitely do that. It's a good place to jump off of if you're at the island.
Yeah, it's a completely open cockpit, so it's very versatile. You can put any kind of loose furniture, you could put lounge furniture, we could put a dining table here, so it's a good size to entertain.
This non-skid paint looks brand new. That was definitely upgraded.
Yeah.
So what immediately stands out, which is so cool if you're thinking of it as a liveaboard, of course also as a weekender, but I'm looking at this as a really cool possibility for liveaboard, so that's how I'm going to approach it. But of course you guys don't have to live on it. Check out these doors here. I mean, this is pretty neat to be able to have on the boat of this size, also this age, of this style, that it's completely open concept. It opens up so nicely here. Tiny little step, not too bad.
Oh yeah, that feels very open actually.
Cool, huh?
Going inside, yeah.
The windows are very large. You also have windows here. So if you really want to have some beautiful light all around, or on certain time of the day, like sunset, you can just open up these if the sunset's behind you. I mean, how cool is that?
Like, totally.
This really feels completely open.
So we got brand new furniture in the salon here, brand new carpeting. It really, really makes a difference.
So what do we have here in the salon? We're going to do this a little different because we cannot go up to the Flybridge immediately, you guys. You get to see the salon first. So
walk us through.
Okay, storage right here.
Uh-huh.
And then we have this nice table here. This is not a high-low, but I'm sure you could do one if you want. Drawers here. This is neat.
Oh, is that a storage?
Yeah.
Oh, that's huge.
It's almost big enough for some CDJs.
Yeah, right?
Okay. We have a big TV here. Also, definitely not 1997.
No.
Okay. And then there's
the old
storage EV here. This is where the TV probably used to be back in the days, right?
Potentially, yeah.
Yeah,
there's probably,
I think
also
so,
where your audiovisual equipment is.
Storage. Ice maker. How cool is that? And all of that behind is all storage, and there's some big drawers right there.
Uh-huh.
And you also have your sink here, so this truly is your bar here.
A little vet bar.
Behind the door, looks like we have an AC, and hey!
Sorry, I had to try out these brand new chairs.
And what do you think?
They're very comfortable. They're really, really comfortable.
Yeah,
I like them.
We still have a lot to see.
Oh, you think we should continue on filming?
Let's go.
Okay.
So we have AC and heater?
Yes.
Oh, that's all our
AC control.
Yeah, cooling and heating. Yeah. Awesome.
So let's step up.
Yeah. Do not look at the galley yet. We're going to go straight up to the Flybridge. Don't look.
Okay. Can I mention this here, since we're already in front of us here?
Go ahead.
Very conveniently located, the electrical panel with all the high and low voltage breakers and switches. Everything is labeled. Pretty good position for it. And just looking at this above here, we do have a water maker on board. Village Marine.
Okay, let's go up to the Flybridge. Check it out. These are definitely new cushions. That's been upgraded. So your dinghy storage is right here.
You have a crane right here, and then the dinghy cradles are actually extending out slightly over the end of the superstructure. It's kind of cool, actually. It gives you a lot more space on the Flybridge.
Yeah, absolutely.
Because the dinghy is not taking all the space away. And it's a really heavy-duty cradle, so I wouldn't really be concerned putting the dinghy up on here. I think that's a great spot.
The way the space is laid out, you have these two nice sitting areas here. Then you have your barbecue and the bar in this area. A drink fridge with an ice maker. Some of the things were not replaced to let the new owners have an option to put whatever stuff they want. So the necessary upgrades were definitely done. And some of this stuff, it's really up to you what you want to put in here.
Yeah, maybe you want to put a wine cooler in there or something.
Exactly. Wow.
Access to the barbecue.
Yeah.
Drainage and some storage.
Really nice access. This area here could be easily enclosed if you want to extend your living space here. And all of these have covers. I mean, you could see the snaps here. So
yeah,
that's pretty cool. Marco would not mind the stairs. Yeah. If you guys haven't seen our channel, that's our little dog. These are great.
Yeah, they're great. And then a brand new Bimini top.
Yes. We just replaced ours to white, and I really like it. I'm a fan of it now. It used to be like a darker kind of brown, and now it's white, and it looks pretty cool.
Okay. Yeah, lots of seating up here as well.
This looks brand new as well.
It's a helm bench, not a helm seat.
So the two of us could sit here.
Yeah.
I don't know if you'd like that.
And then, I mean, how about how high up we are?
Super high, you guys.
Just, let's compare this. Next to us is a Marquis 72, and we are taller.
We're definitely taller up here, for sure.
Than the Marquis.
Great for whale watching and spotting, fish spotting. God, there's so many sea lions everywhere. Look, yeah, there's another one right there.
Yeah, I see.
And another one right there. Look.
This is massive here. I mean, honestly, like, look back. Everything is totally open. You can communicate with each other. You can have a party for 15 people up here. No problem.
It's a really good space. I agree. So we have access/storage through these areas, right?
Both sides. So we still have, as it looks, the original electronics on here. This looks like it was upgraded at some point, the bow thruster, remote at least, so we have a bow thruster on board. Everything else looks original. All the shift throttle controls, the Raytheon electronics. I have a little remote here, like a wire remote for the autopilot, where you do your plus minus one, plus minus 10 degrees. The Volvo engine monitors, or, you know, indicators here, like warning lights. And then all analog gauges mounted here forward with, you know, RPMs, engine temperatures, voltmeters, and so on.
Yeah. What would you say to people that say, like, well, why didn't they replace the electronics?
If I would be remodeling this boat, I would have not changed it either, because that's something which you want to leave up to the next owner, because everybody has different preferences on their electronic packages, and you want to leave that up to the next person.
And if someone really buys it as a condo in the water, and they're not really planning to go far past like just Catalina and back or something, technically they could just live with this, right? They don't need to spend the money.
They wouldn't care anyways, yeah. Well, and in terms of actually taking this boat out and going out to some whale watching or just cruising to the island, the visibility on this boat is extremely well. You see everything.
Do you think this connects to the masthead? Maybe. Like in a hotel rooms where
you have the toilet
and the masthead that you never touch.
Yeah.
Never touch that thing.
I never touch it.
What's next? Check out how cool it looks up there.
Yeah, massive foredeck too. Let's go.
Okay. It's nice that it drops you right into the galley. Don't look, you guys. We're gonna go to the starboard side. Out of this awesome sliding door. Rails everywhere. Wow, this is tall.
This is comfy.
And you've got that little space there as well. So you can go pretty far back, actually. Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah, you could easily come up here and even climb over here if you really
had to.
Yeah,
you have the side gate here to go to get out. So
you can open the door and just go that way. All right.
Very comfortable walkway.
What do we think about this bow?
That's a good size bow.
Yeah, you can definitely add cushions right here. This would be, I think, the spot.
Or
you can
actually cushion
this whole thing if you wanted to. Again, it all depends how you would use your boat. So it is a bit of an expense if you wanted to do it. So that's your decision if you buy this.
You know what I would do? I'd just get a couple of bean bags.
Yeah, I think that would be cool.
That would be really nice, sitting in the front, having your sundowners.
So easy, and you just put them, just store them away.
Hatch to the VIP cabin.
Mm-hmm. And the bow pulpit.
That's right.
The Titanic spot.
Mm-hmm. All right. Yep.
Okay.
Okay. let's go.
Let's go? You didn't say anything about this. There is an anchor here.
Anchor right here, windlass right there, and the foot remote switches for the anchor, and a looks like a deck wash, maybe fresh water, not sure. Let's go back inside. You want to go
on this side? This is a sunshade to go in the front of this massive windows here to create shade, to protect the glass. Great to have. This is actually the type of mesh I was talking about, that you could create a little enclosure there in the very back.
It keeps the boat cooler.
Yeah, so that's brand new. You could see it. So that already exists. You don't have to spend money on it. It's something you absolutely should have on every boat, especially in California or Florida.
It's kind of like a pilot house setup.
Yeah.
Because we're definitely raised up a couple of steps, right?
Mm-hmm.
This is a massive settee.
Such a nice
home office.
I would love to have this space. It's also great to be able to have dinner. I mean, for two or small family, you know, of one or two kids, it'd be great space.
For sure. And everything, again, completely open. I can see all the way to the back deck. I could see someone standing on the swim platform. I mean, it's really nice and open, this entire boat.
And it's got that light color Navigator style wood, which we normally see on the Navigators. Mm-hmm. It feels bright and airy. I think it works.
For sure.
So you did that. Then we have a brand new fridge.
Yeah,
so
amazing.
So jealous.
Freezer on top, fridge on the bottom.
That is massive. It's so much bigger than ours.
It is really big.
How is it possible? Is it wider?
It's taller.
And taller.
Yeah.
And it's still got a freezer.
Oh, it's a good size fridge.
All right. Moving into the galley forward. Okay. We have a 3-burner cooktop. There's a trash compactor. Again, you can decide, you can choose to keep it or lose it. Totally your choice. Tons of storage down here. Let's look at these drawers here. That's a great. Huge sink. And actually a garbage disposal. That's cool. It's a cute little spice rack.
Yeah.
Okay, this here is more storage. It's not bad. It's pretty good here. Ginormous convection microwave oven.
Well, you have another big storage actually underneath the table.
Yeah. Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Wow, it's huge. And you have some underneath the helm as well if you want to use that for your galley.
And then I guess that would be for maybe, you know, snacks or glassware potentially.
Or just, you know, dishes and stuff too, whatever you want to put there. We just replaced our microwave. We decided like we'd rather have a fancy toaster oven that we could use like as an oven. So I'd probably do the same if I was buying it.
Or pizza oven.
It's plenty of space here, so you can decide what you use.
I haven't had breakfast.
You haven't had breakfast? That's why you're like not...
I'm totally hungry.
All there. You haven't had breakfast?
Mm-mm.
Can't tell.
Did you have breakfast?
Yeah.
Okay.
Brand new carpet underneath the dinette as well. Oh, what's this?
More storage.
Nice. I like it.
Let's go through the helm. So this is a lower helm. Again, it has a helm bench. Pretty cool.
No, this is redone.
This I'm has like, to be new,
if
right?
If this is original, then it's incredible. Then, no, it's then, definitely
then
redone.
Then this must have been redone,
yeah,
too.
Yeah, it's totally redone. A really good job. I actually like it. It kind of goes with the style of the yacht. I couldn't
it
even
does.
Tell. And I was like, this is in perfect condition. There is no way. This is definitely new.
Yeah, it
oh,
has
that's
to be
cool.
new.
All right, what's at the helm?
Similar to what we have seen up on the Flybridge, we have analog gauges for the engines. Of course, our warning lights from the Volvo engines right there. Throttle control, shift control, and then we do have our bow thruster remote control right here. And then the same like on the upper helm, we have the Raytheon electronics, which look like they came with the boat when it was brand new.
Mm-hmm.
And then here we have the trim tab remote control. Forgot to mention, what the heck is that? Hello, Moto.
It's a relic. Look, it's got a little antenna.
Okay, so you got it.
Hey. Oh.
Wow.
Beep, 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 beep.
No, it doesn't work. You got to pull out the antenna.
Hello? Hello?
Moto.
Can you hear me?
Oh, and I forgot to mention the VHF radio side here on the starboard side.
It's a digital personal communicator, okay?
Mm-hmm.
Don't make fun of it. Rico, does it have a stabilizer?
Yes, it does. It what? Does have a stabilizer, which is not that common on boats that age and that size. So, really cool feature to have on this yacht.
That's amazing!
Yeah, I don't think there are many 56 footers built before in 2000 which have that.
That's pretty amazing. I mean, I don't know if this was originally here or if somebody edited. I would think maybe somebody edited in 2000s or something, but what a great upgrade.
Yeah, especially for a pretty tall boat. You know, it might be a little more top heavy than other models, and with a stabilizer, you just get rid of the roll.
That just opened up to a whole bunch of people that maybe were not considering this
yep.
as a yacht. So, pretty awesome feature. I think it's worth a lot of money.
Let's check out the staterooms.
Okay. Don't have to ask me twice. What
also,
is
brand new carpet.
Oh, that's big.
Oh, more storage.
Interesting. And this has actually an outlet. So, you could move your microwave down here, maybe. You know, put it here.
Or any other, like, kitchen, you know, equipment which needs to be charged or whatever.
Yeah, I don't know about, like, a coffee maker, but some kind of kitchen equipment, and you can actually have a proper oven here and put the microwave here. You could have both. How cool is that? Let's keep going. This is neat. We're gonna go port. This is a big cabin for
it
a
is.
Guest cabin. You guys keep in mind, it's a 56. It is pretty large. This bed here can easily sleep two people.
Closet? Oh no!
Full washer and dryer. Separate units. That is pretty special. Again, great liveaboard. This is cool because this is a pocket door, so you can nicely secure it, but you can leave it open to just kind of give you a little bit more space if you're using this as your laundry room and stuff. You don't constantly have to open the door here.
Also, very large hanging locker.
Yeah, good size closet. There's a drawer down there. This is neat.
Cool.
What a great cabin. I like it. Okay, and then we go forward. And this is not our master, you guys. This is a VIP. This yacht has a three cabin layout. So our master is aft, and it's completely separate and private. Pretty cool. Queen size bed, at least. It's kind of got a big wings there.
I think on the winglets, it's king size, but
it's big.
It's kind of like if you average it out, it's like a large queen, I guess.
Huge closets everywhere.
Yeah.
I'm going to say I'm a little bit jealous right now.
Lots
of
storage.
All of this storage here.
Oh, wow. That's huge.
Why didn't we buy a Navigator, Rico? We didn't see a layout like that. That's not very common, right?
No.
We've seen some other Navigators when we were looking, which didn't seem to have not nearly as much living space.
They had different layouts somehow.
This is a good one. This feels like an aft cabin motor yacht.
It does,
mm-hmm.
especially with the separate master.
And there's another storage all the way forward there. There are two drawers down here, massive, and drawers here, little, not drawers, but little storage spaces.
Mm-hmm.
This is a fabulous little guest cabin. And here we have an entrance to the shared head. I'll see you on the other side.
Okay. Hello.
This head is shared between these two cabins. Got a pocket door to give you more space. Your head is right there. All of these are, wow, This is impressive.
Lots of storage.
Yeah, pretty cool. You've got a porthole here that you can open up. Great storage everywhere. And we have a good size shower. Yeah, it's nice. It's a good size.
With a little bench, huh?
I want to see the master. This is already pretty cool.
Let's go check it out.
So we go all the way back through the salon and we come to our own private entrance. It's got a door. Come on down.
Oh, wow.
Ta-da!
What?
I'm gonna call it. It is a king size bed.
It is a king size.
Wow. So there's a little step up here, but you can walk completely all the way around.
That's massive.
Really nice. This looks brand new. Is this
new? Did I say massive already?
You said massive a few times.
I think I did.
It's unexpected. I don't expect to see this kind of size of a bed in here. And it's pretty tall. I'm standing on this whole thing here and I can still fit.
Mm-hmm.
So if I'm down here, it's definitely tall,
good,
you guys.
Very good headroom for sure.
I'm 5'7", so what do you think?
Yep.
I mean, it's like 6'2", 6 something. This is super interesting, the way they did this. Oh.
Gonna unlock, yeah, just close the door, I guess.
Check this out. Whoa.
Wow.
Yeah, and even got shelves in there.
This is a huge closet.
Sweet, good space to put a safe. And this TV here, so you don't have to settle for a small TV, it just slides over. So you have access to another.
Oh, that even extends further to the outboard side.
Yeah, look at this. Look how big it is. It goes all the way in there. Partly cedar lined closets have a whole bunch of space behind this TV. If you want to put some more EV stuff here, like your Apple box or whatever, that would be good space for it. And underneath here is a huge closet again.
That's enough closet space for sure.
Yeah. And there's drawers here. More drawers. Wow. And that brings us to, oh, this is cute, a really good workspace. I guess you could put a screen here and actually really work. If you want a private space, like if you have, you know, kids that are in school or something and they need to do their homework upstairs and you want to work, you can totally do this here. Great makeup area as well. Tons of drawers here. And there's space here. And what is going on with our portholes? We have 4 portholes?
Yes, so easily create some cross breeze here, which is kind of cool.
So you're not really all the way aft, you're kind of midship.
You are midship.
So this is a good stable space. This is going to be a very comfortable cabin. Ready to see the master head?
Yes.
Okay, come on in. Wow, that totally feels really tall. It's an illusion.
Oh, because of the mirrored ceiling?
Mirrored ceiling for a minute. I was like, that's really tall. But I mean, it is tall.
Yeah.
Similar size head, a little bit more room here. And you have all this storage here. Really nice. Porthole. Wow, this is really screwing with me. It's like storage here as well.
And there's some more storage behind you,
medicine
right?
Medicine cabinet.
Oh, there's more too.
Wow. Cool. And all of this too. What? Great for towels.
Yeah. And then I think looks like similar size walk-in shower like we saw.
No, this is bigger.
It's bigger?
Yeah, for sure.
Okay.
This is definitely
bigger. Oh yeah, it's bigger.
I mean, it's a one size shower.
It's a one person shower.
It's a one person shower, but a very comfortable one.
I think both of us could fit in there.
It is a one person shower. Get out. It's not bad, you guys. I mean, we definitely fit. All right, what are we going next? Engine room?
Lazarette and engine room.
Let's do it. The wood is in a pretty good condition.
Yep.
This would make a great condo on the water. A condo you can take out on the weekends for harbor cruises. You can go to the islands.
Great living space for sure.
Yeah, this could be a lot of fun for a family.
All right, let me check out the Lazarette.
All right, let's see it. I haven't seen the Lazarette yet, you guys. Wow, this is bigger than I thought it would be.
Oh, wow.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, I want to see it too.
I'll see you later.
Oh, I guess I watch it when I'll look after you get out.
All right. So here at the stern of the boat, our hydraulic steering, the rudder posts, really good accessibility. That's awesome. Then we have some fuel tanks here, all the way aft, one on each side. Raycor filters, or the fuel filters. What are you doing there? Chilling.
This is so nice.
Okay.
Rico, keep going.
Moving forward, here on the port side, we do have a generator. battery storage here on the starboard side, just a blanket on top right now. Going further forward, that's a pretty comfortable engine room actually. I mean, I know you can't stand up in here, but it is a really comfortable engine room. So this boat comes with Volvo Penta TMAD 72s, very clean bilge area. The whole engine room looks extremely clean. So let's step further forward, like kind of midship. There is a Village Marine water maker, and there are the fins, the stabilizer fins. Amazing. I mean, that is really cool to have that on that size yacht for sure. You got a couple more batteries mounted there. This is a reservoir for the stabilizers, the hydraulic fluid. There is a hot water heater mounted right there. Fire suppression system. Everything is super easy accessible here, actually. I really like it. Got the sea strainers right here. One is mounted here on the port side. The other one is here on the starboard side. Engines look very clean. Yeah, it's a good engine room.
All right, you guys, this complete out tour of
this Navigator.
This Navigator.
56 Sundance.
Hey! You're hijacking my outros.
56 Sundance.
Make sure you stay for the outtakes. Don't leave yet. This was my idea to have him in the outro. Scratch that terrible idea. Go hold the camera.
And outtakes in general was my idea, just FYI.
That is very, very true. All right, you guys, I hope you enjoyed it. Please drop in the comments below what you thought about it. We really, really appreciate all your likes, comments. Double appreciate your double comments. A lot of you are saying you wish you could double like a video. Me too. Please tell it to YouTube. You should be able to like it as many times as you want, right? Thank you for subscribing. I recently checked. There's only 15% of you guys are actually have your notification bell on. So it's right there. It's a little bell right there. Just click that. And also check in your YouTube settings on your YouTube app on your phone that your notification thing is on as well. If you have both of those on, you will never miss a new video.
Exactly.
There's a reason I wanted to sit here. Now I forgot what it was. See? Forgot. This yacht is for sale. If you guys are interested, all the contact information will be in the description underneath the video. You can also reach out to us and we will put you in contact with the seller. Ciao!
All right. Ciao!
Enjoy the outtakes!
That's good. It's gonna be the whole time, I think.
Hey guys, welcome back to NautiStyles. Hey guys, welcome back to... No, why am I wearing these flip-flops? I didn't want to wear them.
Why not? Don't go barefoot on the dock here with sea lions poop everywhere.
Hey guys, welcome back to NautiStyles.
Yeah, we're good on that one. So now to do the rest.
Sorry, let me get something out of my eye here. Okay. Stop it,
I
please.
Should spring like a long pole, or like a tripod. Walk away, have a coffee.
You're making me laugh, stop
right.
It. Do you mind, man? Wow.
Cough like a human almost.
Oh,
so
man.
Weird.
This is too soon.
Should we wait anyways?
Mm-hmm. Wait? Should we wait?
Wait.
Should we wait a little bit?
Let's just wait.
Oh, you know what? Hello?
Anybody there?
Hello?
No.
No. Nobody there.
Wasn't for you.
This one is actually blah, 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 blah.
Really cool.
Stop playing with electronics.
Oh, sorry.
All right.
Oh, hang on.
What?
Hey, buddy. How you doing? What's up?
He's just wondering when we leave so he can try to get on the swim platform. It's like, you guys almost done?
Oh, for the outros?
How is it? Why don't I see? I feel like we missed something. The whole time. Something about this. Something about this. Something about this we missed.